Hi everyone, in this video we are going to talk about smoothing splines. So let me type the title here so that you know what I'm talking about. Smoothing splines. So we are going to start with a dataset first. And the dataset we are going to use is from a package. So we are going to install a package called ISLR2. So this is a book, Introduction of Statistical Learning Using R. And I'm going to run that line so that the package is installed and we can actually load that package and we can use the datasets in the package. And the data we are going to use is called auto. So I'm going to just run that line. If you're curious, you can definitely run question mark with auto so that you can see a description of the dataset, like the number of observations and the details of each variable. And what we are going to do right now is to start simple. So let's attach the dataset first so that we know all the variables we are talking about will automatically from this dataset. And then we can define our first simplest model, which is a linear model using MPG miles per gallon with weight. So if you run that line, that means you're defining a regression model with MPG being the response and weight being the predictor. So now we can easily draw a plot using, we can do X and Y, so weight and then MPG. So you can see the scatter plot is shown on the right side. And then we can add a line. So we can add the line from the model, the regression model we defined. So if you do abline, sorry, I had a typo, abline, and then you can see that line is added. If you want it to be more like clear for the line, you can actually change the color. So you can specify it to be red so that you can see that red line is the regression line that we defined here. So this is a simple regression line which describes how can we use weight to predict MPG. As the weight goes up, the MPG will go down. So that's the pattern. And we can start with a simple spline now. And for a spline, we are talking about degrees of freedom. So if you are talking about a spline with 2 degrees of freedom, that means we are only adding a regression line as we added before. So if you have 2 degrees of freedom, that's a simple linear regression line with 2 parameters to estimate. So what we can do here is to define our spline with 2 degrees of freedom, and then we can use a function called smooth.spline, and then we type our x, our y, and then we type the df. Df equals 2, so that's our spline 2. And then we can actually add that spline 2 line to our picture. Let's use color blue. So I'm going to run these 2 lines together, and you can see what change we just made. So you can see a blue line is added, and that blue line is exactly the red line. So that's a 2-degree freedom spline. And then we can actually try on a spline 3. The easiest way to do it is to copy line 12 and line 13 and to change that number 2 to number 3. So we are adding a degree of freedom 3 smoothing spline. And you can change the color maybe to green. And you can run these two new lines, and you can see there is a little change to that smoothing spline. It's a little curved, and that is actually a quadratic spline. We just added one more freedom, degree of freedom, to that line. You can be more dramatic, like you can change that spline to 20 degrees of freedom and name that spline 20. And then you can add that line E, and by naming the color maybe brown. So you can change that, and you can see if you zoom the picture, you can see it better. So that brown line, very vividly, you can see that's the degree of freedom 20. And even more, you can make it spline with degrees of freedom 100. So you can name it spline 100, and then you may do the color. What color do you want? Maybe orange. And then we run those, and you can see what changes we are making. So you can see, as we add more degrees of freedom to the smoothing spline, we are creating a more wiggly line, and those lines are like more and more mimicking what our data is, like in more details. You know, when we started with spline number 2, we are having a straight line, the blue line and the red line. And then we get the green one, right? We get the green one, and then we get the brown one, and now we have the orange one. So you can see that's what the smoothing spline does. But spline 100 is very flexible, and it matches the data most closely, but it would not be powerful for prediction. Okay, that's about it for smoothing splines.